Of course, stocks did fall from their session highs after the Fed signaled this afternoon that it will probably raise interest rates in March. Let's bring in David Stockman, former Reagan budget director and the author of Trumped. David, good to see you. Thanks for being here. You think that the Treasury is going to fall short because of these tax cuts, right? About a $1.2 trillion short?
Yeah, this tax cut will cost the first year $280 billion. We already had a $700 billion deficit built in. They're adding $100 billion to appropriations. You got $100 billion for disaster relief. That's $1.2 trillion in the 10th year of a recovery. It's unheard of.
Well, there's certainly, it's absolutely true that they're not cutting back on spending, and that's a disgrace. Washington is always spending too much money. But don't you believe that tax cuts do generate more income, more revenue?
No, not this one. And even if it generates 1% more growth next year, that'd be $200 billion of GDP, $40 billion of revenue. But you're giving away $280 billion. You got a $1.2 trillion to borrow. And you've got the Fed clearly signaling for the first time in 30 years that they're not monetizing the debt. In fact, they're shrinking
right.
their balance sheet.
No, they've got to sell $600 billion worth of bonds.
Yields, that's see, the point is there's no free lunch. Yields are going to rise.
And that's the only way you can sell bonds when you have that much coming in the market.
Okay.
But again, getting back to the revenue from the tax cuts, back during your era in the Reagan administration, after the tax cuts kicked in 1983, there was an increase for the Reagan era of 51.4% of revenue. If there is that kind of increase in revenue because of this tax cut, it ain't going to be so bad.
No, that's not. That's just a mythology about the Reagan era. There was a huge.
Wait a minute. You're dumping on your own era?
Yes, I am, because I want the truth to be known. And that is there was a huge recession. There was six quarters of bounce.
Okay,
back.
But hold on, David, please.
I have to get the facts out. David, okay?
The fact is that the tax cuts did not kick in until after the recession. Once the tax cuts kicked in 1983, the recession was pretty much over. 1983, we grew by 4%. That was a hell of a juxtaposition from a recession.
All right. Well, I was there, and I think I know more about it than you do, frankly.
I'm just quoting the facts from the Treasury Department.
The fact is, during the 8 years of the Reagan administration, real GDP grew at 3.5%.
But the tax cuts did not cut in until 1983.
It doesn't matter.
Of course it does. But look at these growth stats, David. 4% in 1983, over 7% in 1984. These are huge numbers. Don't you think we're going to have at least part of that bump as a result of these tax cuts?
No, because that was right after a deep recession. We're now 10 years after the last recession. It's apples and oranges. These numbers that you're using don't make any sense.
Well, and the numbers that you see on the left-hand side of the screen there are from the Treasury Department. So
well, the Treasury Department is run by people who don't have a clue about real economics, okay?
Right.
I'm sorry.
All right, well, we got to run, but I have to ask, when do you think this is going to... One thing I have to agree with you on, David, is that they're going to be selling a lot of bonds in the market, both the Treasury and the Fed, and the only way you can sell that many bonds in that amount is by raising interest rates. So I agree with you there. I do believe interest rates are going to go higher. How much higher, and how is that going to affect inflation?
Well, there's 200 or 300 basis points higher interest rates. That means bondholders are going to be taking 20, 30, 40% losses. There is going to be carnage in the bond market, which will stop this economy short after a 10-year recovery, so-called, that's been the weakest in history.
Okay.
The idea that this massive deficit in this tax or this deficit finance tax cuts are going to rescue the economy is so wrong.
David, I love you to death, but I got to say, if Ronald Reagan was alive, he'd take you to the woodshed again. Again, he'd take you to the woodshed.
All right.
I was alive during
that
time. All right, David Stockman, thank you very much. Great to see you as always, David. I appreciate it.
Great.